Girl guides and brownies gathered at the Vigie Complex to celebrate what their movement calls Thinking Day, the joint birthday of the founder of the Girl Guide and Boy Scout movement. The parade and rally also marked the commencement of a week of special activities for the Girl Guide movement, which boasts about 2,000 members locally. But the chief commissioner for the Girl Guides movement says the numbers have fallen.
Some of the groups, especially in the northern area, Castries and the surrounding, have not been functioning for a little while now because I think people get interested in other things that we currently do not have the capacity to provide. But we are working on it and working on building up our groups again.
The Girl Guide movement hopes within 4 years' time to have guide units in every school on the island. Currently, the movement has units in only 10 educational institutions and expects that within the planned expansion, it will be able to pass on life skills to more young women.
We join in order to keep, to be occupied, to not to get into any trouble, to have yourselves occupied to do different things. You learn different things in guides and work for badges, which will give you confidence and encourage you to do other things in school also.
One of the big challenges facing the local Girl Guide movement, however, is attracting sufficient volunteers.
Many girls want to belong to the organization, but we do not have enough leaders to go around. When young people who are in the movement leave school and so on, they are now building their career, so for a while they are not available to continue. However, most of them do come back after they have settled in their career.
Guiding was first introduced in St. Lucia in July of 1925. The St. Lucia Girl Guides Association was registered about 1 year later on 26 June 1926. The Girl Guide movement exists in some 145 countries and boasts a membership of over 1 million young females. For the DBS News World, Melissa Paul reporting.